श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तः पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ ब्रह्मानन्दं परमसुखदम् केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यम् एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। सदाचार is to add meaning and value to all our actions. Sadachar is called good behavior, good conduct. Sadachar is to make our entire life meaningful, plan our life in such a way that every stage of life becomes productive and meaningful. And not just the entire life, but every day, from the time you get up to the time you sleep, it becomes meaningful. As we said, one is samskara, the other is the outside knowledge that we gain, literacy. But what is more important? Not just the outer knowledge that we gain, but this inner culture and values that we hold, it makes our behavior more beautiful. So this is what sadachar is. We talked about jivancharya. Jivancharya is a life plan. And the second thing was what? Dinacharya. Dinacharya means what? A daily plan. So today we said we will look into the daily plan. From the time we get up to the time we sleep, how to make our life meaningful and beautiful. That's what we are going to do. Now, see, anything that we do, there is an Indian way of doing it. I told you yesterday, America is very successful because what? It sold its lifestyle to everyone. We're all following that lifestyle, consciously, unconsciously, and we've bought it. We've not, and anything against that seems what? Ridiculous and old-fashioned, as they say. Anything is, ah. So I don't know really how much we can reverse. So basically, what we're talking about is that not really doing different things, but doing things differently. Okay? We are not talking about what? Doing different things, but we are going to be talking about what? Doing things differently. Now, everyone gets up in the morning. Yes. You can't change that. Now, how do you get up? Sorry, how do you get up? You get up. You open your eyes and you get out of bed. No. Let's do it differently. So, what is the Indian way of doing it? Come on, it can't be different. You sleep on a bed and you have to get down. No, there is a way. As I told you, to make every small thing in our life meaningful. We have this, I don't know, have you heard about Shodashas Sanskara? In our culture, from the time you are born, in fact, from the time of conception to the time of death, every major development in your life or stage of your life is marked by a samskar or a ceremony or what you would call in English a sacrament. Are you aware of that? When the child is born, it is called Jata Karma. Jata Karma is what? The ceremony at the time of birth. When you are born, yes. Jata Karma. I will have to do that today. Jata Karma. What is Jata Karma? Where? And I'll have to go into that now today. If otherwise, let me just talk about the birth one then. You know, when the child is born, Saraswati is prayed to. Bhagwan may, and you know, when the first time that the mother feeds the child, she prays to Saraswati that the milk is what? The milk of knowledge with which I nourish my child. What a beautiful thought. The milk of knowledge. And she prays to Lakshmi. Why Lakshmi? And to Prithvi, that I have come in this world, this child has come, may the Mother Earth support her and nourish her all her life or his life. Yeah, very, very beautiful. So now even that becomes what? Now the parents know, the mother doesn't know. The child doesn't know at that time, but the parents know this. And then you have a naming ceremony, and then the first time the child eats, there is a ceremony. The first time the child goes out of the house, there is a ceremony. Are you all aware of these things? Yes or no? Half of you are. See, the elder people are, the younger. It was your job to have passed it to your next generation. Okay, fine. Then, so at each stage, similarly, as you get up, from the time you get up, whatever you're going to be doing, so each time is marked. You know, you pause, you think, you make it more meaningful and you go ahead. Actually, every moment has to be like that, but anyway, you have. So you get up in the morning. And the first thing is Pratar Uthana. Prataha means early, early. The emphasis on the word. And there's only one way to get up early in the morning, and that is to sleep early. Do you agree with me? Yes or no? Because if you sleep late, you can get up early morning, but you are in no condition to do anything effectively. Agreed? So the only way is to sleep early. Now, so first you sleep. And how do you sleep? That comes with the fact, how do you sleep? You sleep? No. How do you sleep? As you sleep, what do? You, first of all, before going to sleep, you say, what? Karacharana kritamva, kayajam karmajamva, shravananayanajamva, manasamva paradham, vihitam avihitamva, sarvametat shamasva, jaya jaya karunabde, shri mahadeva shambho. Don't worry about the words, saying, God, Swamiji, come, you know, you please write it out for me so that I can say. It's available, you know, there's a daily prayers, books and all that. Everything is there, that's okay. The important thing is the feeling. Even if you don't know the words, the feeling. Oh, Bhagwan, through the day I may have consciously, unconsciously, knowingly, unknowingly done some wrong, may have done, or I know I have done something to someone. How? Kara, through my hands. Charana, through my feet. Kritamva, kayajam, with my body, with my, you know, I may have heard things I shouldn't have been hearing, I may have spoken things, I may have seen things, so please forgive me, blanket forgiveness from your side. Shamasva, please forgive me, I'll try not to do any of that tomorrow. So you sleep with a clean mind. You understand? So you go to sleep. And how do you go to sleep? Very nice. Remembering the Lord. When kids are there, I always say Hanuman Chalisa and go to sleep. Bhuta Pisacha Nikata Nahi Aave Mahavira Javanama Sunave. Just go to sleep. No question of bad dreams at all. I remember as a kid, you know, born in a typical Gujarati family. So our life was pervaded with Jai Shri Krishna. You get up in the morning, The mother wakes you up with what? What? Beta, utho, Jai Shri Krishna. So first thing you get, Jai Shri Krishna. Firstly, you have to say that. Before going to school, you have to say what? Mummy Jai Shri Krishna. And if you have not said Mummy Jai Shri Krishna, and you go out of the house, that mother won't eat. Are you aware of that? I'm sure your mothers would have done something like that. So you know you have to say. So sometimes you would forget, we would run back home and say, Mummy Jai Shri Krishna, and run out again. Because we know she would not have eaten all the time we would be outside. She didn't have to then tell us, you know, force it. Because you know, I mean, which child doesn't want the mother to eat? You know, it's too painful a thought. So you just go back and say, Mummy Jai Shri Krishna, and run out again. You come back home, what? Jai Shri Krishna. You go to sleep, and there was this very sweet little thing we used to speak when we went to sleep, before going to sleep. It's in Gujarati. It's a very sweet little. Suta saran, bhoi maran, aankhe jaada, kaane taada, Shri Krishna jina dwar ugaada. What? At the time of, and there's so much of Vedanta which I realized only when I studied Vedanta, when I grew big in this. When you go to sleep, aankhe jaada, you don't see anything, kaane taada, you don't hear anything, but Bhagwan is ever awake. So as kids, you know, we have a lot of imagination. So we used to imagine, you know, Bhagwan is there, everything else is closed, but he is awake and he's looking at us, he's smiling, and looking at his face, you drop off to sleep. Where is the question of bad dreams? Supposing we've forgotten it and we did get a bad dream, the first thing you do, mummy says, Suta Saran Bolyata. Did you say Suta Saran? No, okay, Suta Saran God. Are you understanding? If you can do that. Supposing the child also is not able to do that. I remember it's this time when we would get up to Narsimhatta's Prabhatyas. You know, those beautiful songs that were there. That's the first thing you get up to. It's going on in the background. When you're getting up, you just hear these beautiful, but you don't know, understand anything at that time. But that beautiful sounds, it remains with you so much. And as you get up, the first thing we were doing is beautiful sunrise from my house. So we would just be taken to the window and we'd be standing there. And then we see, oh, the birds are coming today. This is there. You get up with this lovely, beautiful thought. Ave to utho, late thank you. You got there. Oh, again. I'm not going to do this. And then sometimes the music also going on, the TV is going on, bang, 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 boom, bada, boom. You know, your child gets up like that, what happens the whole day? Are you with me? And this is all possible even in this day and age. Do you agree with me? Bolo na. It's not impossible, it's possible to do these little things which make, and it has a impact, lifelong impact on the whole. And every day in the house, the whole atmosphere becomes very different. And I hope you believe it's all very practical. Yes or no? Possible? Yes. Very simple. You do it according to your religion, according to your interest, it doesn't matter. But that whole atmosphere in the morning as you get up must become sattvic. Must become very quietening, very inspiring, very holy. So, pratha uttana. First of all, you get up early. It's the best time to get up. You're ahead of time then. You know, otherwise you're not fighting and all the time. Don't get up. Then, what do? Immediately, you remember God. First thing. Okay, if you don't believe in God, remember something nobler and higher and greater in you. Bas. Something which is divine, something which is whatever you consider. It doesn't matter. Remember. Pratasmaranam, it is said. Pratasmaram irudisan Svuradatma tatvam Satchit sukham paramaham sagatim turiyam. Remember the Lord, remember whichever, it doesn't matter how. Then, after that, karadarshanam. So, step one is prataruthanam, then pratasmaranam. Third is what? Karadarshanam. I told you yesterday. Karagre vasate lakshmi. Why? Because this represents self-effort. I will use all my effort for gaining knowledge, gaining wealth, and gaining something noble and great. This is the promise that you make yourself in the morning. Karadarshanam. Having done this, Bhagwan has given. What do? You step out of, this all is on the bed, huh? And then, the minute you step, what do? Samudra vasane devi parvatastana mandale Vishnupatni namastubhyam padasparsham kshamasvame. You say, Swamiji, early in the morning, so many shlokas to remember. You don't worry. The bhava, the feeling is more important than the shloka. The idea is that, O Mother Earth, I am going to step on you. May I not desecrate you, may I not do anything which can be harmful to you, because you are nourishing me. May I have that same type of forbearance and forgiveness that you have. Do you know, I tell you, it's such a beautiful feeling. I'll just explain to you the difference in the culture of the West and this. The attitude, more than anything, the attitude. Do you know who was the first person to climb Mount Everest? There were two people, Edmund Hillary and Sherpa Tenzing. These two people were the first to climb Mount Everest. What do you think Edmund Hillary did when he climbed Mount Everest? He put the flag of his country and said, I have conquered Mount Everest. What are the words? What are the words? I have conquered Mount Everest. And what did Sherpa Tenzing do? Sherpa Tenzing is a Hindu, Nepali Hindu, right? What did Sherpa Tenzing do? He fell at his feet. He fell down and he did namaskar. And they considered, you know, the Mount Everest is considered as a Devi in Nepal. Are you aware of that? As a Devi. So he fell and says, forgive me for putting my foot on your head. What? Are you understanding the difference now? In the culture, one says, I have conquered nature. The other says, I have not conquered. How can you conquer nature? Are you can conquer nature? That Mount Everest allowed you to climb. Is it true or not? Few stones here and there and you'd have been at the bottom of Mount Everest, not the... Are you understanding that? But look at the attitude. I have conquered. Now, this is the typical Western attitude. Whereas, what is the Indian attitude? What? Not you have not conquered. What? How can you conquer nature? You live in harmony with nature. You don't go around conquering nature. And all the present... Have you seen one movie called The Inconvenient Truth? Please see it. It's made by Al Gore, the ex-prime president of the United States. And all those disasters that come about. It's a cultural thing, basically. It's a lifestyle that you follow that causes all the harm. For thousands of years, Indian culture lived, and we never believed in exploiting nature. We never had all those problems. The same farmland that we were cultivating for thousands of years, in the last 50 to 60 years after independence, more than 40% of farmland in India has become unagricultural. You know, irrigation is not possible there because we've used all those pesticides, we've destroyed it all. Now you can't put anything there. Are you understanding? For thousands of years it was possible. The same land kept on giving us crops again and again and again and again and again. And now in 50, 60 years, gaya. Why? Are you understanding? So you pray to Mother Earth, and then it says, Shubha Darshanam. The first thing in the morning, you see something auspicious and your day goes. So normally in an Indian house, you would have all photos of God all over, plastered everywhere. Is it true or not? And nowadays, you open any teenager's cupboard. What will you see? Bolo. And if they are really small, then WWF, those guys, those, I don't know, you call them men also, you call them creatures, right? More. Horrible. Terminator. Now imagine the first thing in the morning you look at a Terminator. Now what? Prata. It's called Shubha Darshanam. See something auspicious? See the sunrise. The sea. Something very beautiful. Okay, that's how you get up. Then what do? He says, then, see, every small thing was made into a ceremony or a, not a ceremony, a meaningful action, basically, more than anything else. He says, shaucha, when you're clearing your system, you imagine all wrong negativities are coming out of me, washing out of my system. What a wonderful thought. Let everything negative, everything which is wasteful, which is unnecessary, be out of my system. And, you know, what we did was brushing our teeth. Does anyone of you remember doing it with a datun? Anyone? Oh, there is someone at least over here who's actually done a datun. You know what a datun is? It's that stick, neem stick. You go back home, you still find it in some places, not everywhere, you won't even get a datun. But it was very, very good. Automatically brushing and flossing simultaneous. Is it true or not? You didn't have to buy a separate tooth floss, you know? Dental floss, you didn't have to, it just happened. And nowadays, it's such a strange thing. We gave up all this datun and now you have what? Herbal toothpaste. The best extract of what? Neem and this, and then we go and buy. And you know, even foreign companies like Colgate and all, they realize if they want to survive in India, they better do all the herbs. So you have herbal Colgate. Vareva. Haven't you seen such things? Pehle se hum karte the. But that, see, it's a very strange thing. The Western way of doing things, the Indian way of doing things, the Western way, you don't use the thing. You make it into a product and use it. Have you understood that? They won't have straight away garlic. They will have garlic pills. Yes or no? Vitamin from food they don't want. They will extract it, make it into, and then they'll say vitamin drink. Are vitamin drinks directly from that food you take? Nah. We make it into a product, sell it at 5 times the price, and then we feel very happy and says, what do? I take vitamin supplements. But why don't you take the vitamins directly? Nah. Are you understanding? This is their way. And can you imagine how much more of everything is wasted in the process? You create so much of waste. You create so much of pollution as you do your daily routine. Because all natural things are out. Everything unnatural? Yes. If you are meant to sleep at night? No. You sleep in the day. If you are meant to brush with a datun? No. You use a plastic thing and a plastic thing and a plastic thing and a plastic thing and a plastic thing. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Yes. That datun was eco-friendly. Agreed? Yes or no? Prahata. Okay. Then you know what was. So way of life was taila mardanam. Have you heard of that? That there are very few people now who do that every day. But your great-grandfather did it every day. And the mother also. What? Took oil and what? Massaged it all over the body and then bathed. Are you aware of that? Hopefully, I think so, I don't know whether they do it here, but at least back in India, when the child is born, for at least a year almost, they do what? Do they do it here? Ah, thank God. Otherwise, the modern doctors will come and mess that up also. No, don't put oil. And some discovery they'll always make to find out what they, and then they will sell something from patent our oil, put it into some other form and give it back to us. And they say it's from Switzerland. They put oil all over. And have you seen when the child, you know why? Because it's the saying ki what you eat, the tattva, the essence that you get from eating ghee, that same tattva, in fact even more, you get by massaging oil. Are you understanding? Because the oil is absorbed by the skin. If you want to experience this, go into an Ayurvedic hospital or a clinic or something, and they'll put you through all that dhara and this and that, and I tell you, every pore of you, every bit of you will be taking out oil in a little time, you know. So much of it gets absorbed into our very system. And how much of good it does. The bones become strong, the bone marrow becomes strong. Everything, it's so good for your health. So what is that called? Taila Mardanam. Now, we, as a treatment, we will do it. But as a way of life, at least in the south of India still, you know, whenever there's a special function, na, I ask, you know, how do you celebrate Diwali? They say, we do oil, we take an, they call it oil bath. So I said, how do you celebrate a Diwali with an oil bath? They put oil all over. And you know, when you massage, especially your feet and the head, haven't you all done a hair massage with the oil? Aajkal to koi oil naaktu j nathi. And then mate baddha vaal nikli jaye chhe. You know, all the hair, you see those, you see South Indians, their hair, thick, black, dark, long. Haven't you seen that? My God, the amazing hair. Why? They never take out oil from their hair because the minute they wash it, they put it back. Yeah, his hair, nice, beautiful hair. Swamiji, we wouldn't want to do it. Anyway, whatever. What I'm trying to tell you is, it's good for the... And then putting oil, you know, in the ear, and then the ear power. See, we say, I want my ears to become better. I want... We do... All our lifestyle is to make our senses duller, but not to make them better. Are you understanding? For example, you know, listen to all those iPods and mobiles and this and that. Are you understanding the harm that it is doing to your ears and your brain and all that? That we don't bother. Our entire lifestyle is seen to be dulling our senses, dulling our mind, making our senses and mind tireder instead of making them fresher. Whereas this was a lifestyle, everything that you did enhanced the ability of your senses and mind. Are you understanding that? Yes? Complete opposite, complete opposite. So then, taila mardanam, danta dhavanam, it is called danta, in Sanskrit it's called. Then we go to, you get up, then bathing. See, this simple, you say, I don't have time for puja, I don't have time for japa. You bathe every day? Of course, Swamiji. What do you think? Right. So you bathe every day. You can make bathing into a what? A puja. How do you do that? Start the shower. First of all, the water that comes, you know, what? Ganga cha yamune chaiva. You invoke all the holy waters of Ganga, Yamuna and all in the what? Shower. Asmin shavare avahayami. I invoke you in the shower. And start. So what happens? You are taking Ganga snan wherever you are in Mombasa. You understand? And then what do you do? Within you is the Lord, is Bhagwan, Paramatma. Isn't it true? So when you start the shower, you start saying what? Ki, I am giving abhishek to the Lord. What are you doing? Early morning you do Shiva abhishek, right? So, Bhagwan is in my heart and I am doing an abhishek. So, Sahasra Shirsha Purusha, even if you don't know the mantras, the point is don't worry. I may chant mantras, but you may just, the bhava is what is more important. Are you understanding that? So, when you are bathing, automatically puja happens. Because as I told you, otherwise our mind is at least 15 kilometers away from the body. Bathing is happening completely mechanically, right or wrong? Brushing, bathing, everything. Here you are in the present. Have you read of a book called Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle? Talks about now. You remain in the present, in the now, in the here. These are all ways by which you can remain and then making everything more meaningful. Instead of becoming mechanical, it becomes what? Meaningful, that I am praying to the Lord. Okay, by the way, there are many types of bath that they were... There's one called mantra bath. Swamiji, this is very nice. Just say a mantra and it's... Yeah. They do it, you know. I don't know how many of you do a sandhya vandanam. Have you ever done? Anyone doing sandhya vandanam? No one does that. Okay. So, this is something which is very... You know, anyone who wears a yajnopavita... Janu, anyone wears... Oh, at least some people are wearing, at least they're nodding their head. Right? So, yajnopavitam, and you wear, you do every day morning. And in that, you take a bath. There's a special way. Apo hishta mayo bhuvah tanna urje dadhatana maheranaya chakshashe. You know, you put water, sprinkle water, saying the mantras in different parts of your body and you bathe. So, when you're in a hurry, what do you do? No, that's not the meaning. You do a mantra bath. Then there is, see, this is not, I'm making up, it's there in our texts. Then that is, there's another one called Parthivam Snanam, and that is a mud pack bath. Nowadays, every spa gives you what? What? There was one place in some Indonesia where they gave you a herbal what pack. They wrap the whole body in leaves, herbal, you know this, and they wrap you up and all like, and then you come out and you spend what? It's charged, heavy things. What they're trying to, and you know, for beauty, I think they all do like that, no? What do they do? Back at home, they use Multani Mati. I don't know what you use over here. There's a place from Multan where you get that mud, very cheap. And you just put it all over your body, it becomes what? And remember, no one went to beauty parlors. All this was done at what? So this is, and then there's Agneya Snan, where I have actually seen people in the Himalayas, in Gangotri, where it is so cold, and he's just got one cloth wrapped around him, bus, that's it, and he's just sitting there, just shocking, and we were all, you know, like wrapped up and all coats and this. I said, Swamiji, how do you manage this? Only bhasma on his body, what? That is called Agneya Bath. What? Only bhasma snana. They just put the bhasma. They don't feel cold. They're just sitting there like that. Unbelievable. Then there is something called a sun bath. I'm just saying it. It's called Divya Snanam. Nowadays, people pay so much of money, come to these resorts of Mombasa, and you make the money because they want to take what? A sun bath. So it's called Agneya Snanam. These are all there in our scriptures. Huh? So a sun bath is what? And of course our regular bath, and one of the best is Manasik Snanam, and that is meditation, is a thing by which your mind is completely cleansed. Okay, so then you have this Nana, and then we talk. There's a ceremony called Aghamarshan. Aghamarshan, don't worry about the ceremony. The bhava, agha, papa, marshanam, washing away. So what do you do? You take water. What do? You don't breathe in, you breathe out. And you, without looking at, the idea is that if I have done anything, and I know I may have done something wrong, Bhagwan, I wash off this particular sin from, I wash off that guilt of this through this. I mean, the idea is that I won't do it again. All the things that I told you yesterday. So moment to moment, it's not that, you know, you once in a blue moon have a confession or something like that. Daily, morning, evening, two times, you do this sort of a thing and you make your mind pure, clean and pious. This was called Agha Marshanam. I'm just saying all these things. I know you may not do it ever, but you may not see these ceremonies ever. But in case you see something, if you know, at least we must be aware of what that is all. Then there is another one that is called Sandhya. Have you heard of Sandhya? Sandhya is now, dawn and dusk are two beautiful times which Bhagwan has made conducive for something which is very holy, introspective, meditative, contemplative, etc. Don't you see nature at its very best at dawn and dusk? So nature helps you, the whole of nature helps you at that time. So what should you do? Don't spend, that's why they say don't cut your nails at that time, don't go out at that time. What are you supposed to do? Do Devo at that time and do prayers. Have you all understood that? So two times you're supposed to light a lamp and pray. And which are those two times? What? Dawn and dusk. I think in most houses at least once they do the Devo, right? In the morning time. So yeah, they always say Sandhya. Sandhya is the Sandhi Kala. Now, let me just go a little deeper and give you a little better, deeper meaning also. See, when you do meditation, I don't know how many of you do meditation. Sandhya is very important. Sandhya is Sandhi. Sandhi means connection. Joining of two things is called Sandhi. So therefore, the night has ended, the day has not yet started. So this point is called Sandhya. Then the day has ended, the night has not yet started. So that point of meeting is called sandhya. Have you all understood why those two points are important? Similarly, when you do meditation, when one thought has ended, the second thought has not yet started, in that place you meditate on that Paramatma who is there as the underlying witness of all your thoughts. This is called meditative sandhya. Have you understood this? Very difficult. Why? Because our thoughts are going at an unbelievable speed. One thought ending, second thought starting, there is no gap at all. True. So, but that is called meditation. If you can make your mind calm enough, quiet enough, and then you start doing this sort of a meditation, it's a very effective meditation. So it's called sandhya prayers at dawn and dusk. There's a special this. And now I want you to come. See, all this I have said. Okay, let me create a little background of this before I go ahead. You know, I went to London some time back and I was talking to teenagers. And I have a habit of asking questions. So I asked them a question. If you are born again, where would you like to be born? Very interesting conversation. Very, very interesting. I asked them, where would you like to be born? India, England, or America? Guess what answer they gave me? None of them said India. 30% said England and 70% said America. What does that mean? Even in England, they are not. Are you understanding? The ultimate swarga is what? Bolo. I'm telling you, this is my actual experience. Okay, fine. Then the next thing happened. I asked them, I felt a little, in India, what do you like about India? Most of them had been to India. What do you like about India? Finally one or two things. I like the food, like that. Then I said, what do you not like about India? Each one had so many things. Oh, there's corruption, there's that. So many, the big line of things each one said. And you know, I love India. You would have guessed that by now. So for me, it was like arrows being shot at my heart, you know. I said, anyway, I asked for it. Now I can't say anything. I said, keep quiet now. What do you do? Then I asked the next question. I said, if you are born again, what would you like to be born as? A Hindu, a Muslim, or a Christian? All of them said Hindu. I said, ha? At least something, you know. But the next question pains me to date. I wish I had not asked. I would have been a better, you know, I would have saved myself that pain. And I asked the question, why? And you know what the answer they gave me? They said, because you don't have to do anything. Means what? I would rather be a non-practicing Hindu than a practicing Christian or a Muslim. Have you all understood the impact of that? Yes or no? This is exactly what has happened. Most of the Hindus are non-practicing Hindus. Do you agree with me? Yes or no? And this is not the case only in England. It is the case whether in Mombasa or it is in India itself or it is anywhere else in the world. Do you agree with me? Most of them are non-practicing Hindus. Very, very painful. Now, let's go to one more thing. In the Hindu culture, in the Hindu dharma, we were given a choice that you get up early in the morning and either you do japa. So many spiritual practices were given. This choice was such a fantastic thing. It's so strange that people keep complaining about choices and say, why so many choices were given? If one thing was given, it would be easier to do. Have you heard this sort of an argument from people? If it was only one book, it would have been easier. One form of God, it would have been easier. If it was one this, it would have been easier. My dear, you keep saying that. If it was only one soap in the market, easier. Yes or no? You only would complain. Now every shopping mall you go, you have 100 brands of chocolates and 500 brands of clothes. Is it true or not? Do you consider this as not a sign of progress or something bad? Bolo. Tell me. In that you want all the varieties and you want your choices and you want all these things. And here is a culture which gives you those choices. Take one according to your prakriti, according to your tendency, according to your interest. And we keep on complaining. And the best part of it is, you know, we were given a choice. You get up in the morning and either do japa or do puja or do what? Meditation or do parayana or do, you know, go to the temple. We were given this whole range and choice was given. And what did we do? We thought the choice was between doing and not doing. Have you got this point? The choice was not between doing and not doing. The choice was between doing this or doing that. Are you with me? Yes or no? And what happened? We chose not doing and we lost everything. Are you with me? Okay, fine. So, at least one thing, let's become practicing. What? Hindus. Let's become practicing Hindus. Okay, now we go to this very interesting, very important, and very easy. In fact, all saints and all religions recommend this spiritual practice, and that is called japa. Even in Christianity, they have rosary. Even in Islam, they have this. So now we have the japa. Are you all aware of japa? What is japa? Repetition of one name of God. Which name? Any name. We have thousands of names of God. Take any name and repeat it. How do you repeat it? You can do it either loudly, that's called loud japa. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Or Upamshu japa means you say it in such a way that you only can hear, others can't hear. I can hear my voice, but you can't. And or you do it manasik japa. You do it mentally. No one else can hear. I'm actually chanting. You understand? So this is called what? Manasik japa. Which is more difficult? Manasik japa. So you please start. Don't start with that. Maybe because your mind will wander all the time. That is why. So with the speech. Now why the name? See, the japa, yesterday remember I told you, we say concentrate, this thing I was talking about. So concentration, one of the best techniques of developing concentration is doing japa. Because what is concentration? Repetition of one thought. Isn't it true? What is concentration? You're focusing your attention means what? To the exclusion of all else, that one thing you're focusing on. That's called concentration. So, japa is a technique by which you actually, what? Practice, you actually achieve concentration. It's a very strange thing. People say, I gave up japa because I can't concentrate. Are Baba, because you can't concentrate, do japa. Have you understood that? It's a way to develop concentration. You repeat one name again and again. Swamiji, if you have to repeat only, why can't we repeat? Dudum, 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 dudum. We will achieve concentration, isn't it? Instead of doing Rama, 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 dudum, 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 dudum. No, Rama, Rama, Rama. Why? There's something called association of thought. If you repeat dudum, dudum, what comes to your mind? But when you say Rama, Rama, what comes? So in the process of concentration, even purification of the mind happens. Each akshara has its own power. Have you heard of that? Akshara, the word itself. Ra, ka, kha. Each akshara has its own power. So when you're repeating that, it is invoking a certain power within you. Whether you know it or not, it is happening to you. I can keep on talking if I take the topic of japa or any of this, na, it's like endless. But I'm just going to go through it quickly. Now, how do you do a japa mala? Sometimes you use a mala also for doing japa. I'm going to show you, actually demonstrate to you how to use a mala because many people don't know about it. Have you seen a mala? You may be using it. How do you hold a mala? First of all, you hold the mala like that. You balance it on this fingers. This is how you hold a mala. You start with always, there's always one bead sticking out. It's called the meru. Have you seen that? In all your japa malas, there'll be one bead which sticks out. That is called meru. It signifies the infinite truth. or Bhagwan or the Lord, okay? That's what. So you start with that. This is how you balance your mala. And what do? With these two fingers, you actually pull the bead towards you with each name. You keep this finger out. This signifies the ego. What? How do you fight with others? Do you fight like that? Force only comes with this. No other finger, the force comes. This only creates a difference between you and me. So this is called Mr. Ego. So what do? In all your spiritual practices, leave that ego out. Have you understood? So don't do mala like that. Okay? You keep that ego out of your this. And you do. And with each name that you take, Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. You keep moving your bead. Now when you come back to the Meru, what do? You don't go over the Meru. You cannot cross infinity. You turn the bead and you go back. Have you understood that? This is how you do your Japamala. Normally, the Japamala has 108 beads. There's a reason for that also. I can't tell you everything now because it's too much of things to be told. I just tell you the glory and the mahima and the greatness of Japa. Whether you know the meaning, you don't know the meaning. Whether you understand, you don't understand, it is effective. You experience it and find out for yourself. It's easy. This is a sadhana you can do lying down, sleeping, eating, walking. When you are doing your chapatis, you're rolling. Any time you can do this sadhana, it's one of the best sadhanas. Because you don't need anything else other than yourself for doing this sadhana, for doing the spiritual practice. Very effective, very good. You know, there was a man from a village. It's a very interesting story. He asked one big pandit, give me some spiritual practice. I want to do some spiritual practice. Can you help me? So he says, yes. You do the Nama Japa. Which Nama Japa should I do? They said, do this Japa, Agha Mochan. He was a pandit, so he gave a name, Agha Mochan. Agha means Papa and Mochan means one who frees you from Papa, Agha Mochan. So do this name. Now the villager went home, and by the time he went home, he forgot the name. Now he says, now what is the name he forgot? And he remembered part of the name. He says, Ghamochan. What is the name he remembered? Ghamochan. Then, and he was told morning and evening, as you do, whatever you do, you keep saying Ghamochan, Ghamochan. So he was, he would do his farming, whatever he did, Ghamochan, 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 Ghamochan. Anything he did, Ghamochan, Ghamochan. Bhagwan Vishnu in Kailash started laughing. Lakshmiji is saying, why are you laughing? He says, I've got a new name today. So what is the name? I know all your names. Tell me which one is this? Ghamochan. Now she's a sophisticated lady. She didn't like this name Ghamochan at all. Doesn't sound very... You say, what type of a name is this? It doesn't have any meaning also. He says, you may say it has no meaning, but the effect of this name is to be seen, to be believed. You say, what can happen within chanting a name like Ghamochan? He says, you are, it's not even your name. He says, what do you say? He thinks it's my name, full stop. And I know that he thinks it's my name, so it's my name, full stop. But I have to find out, what is the effect of this? He's saying, you go and find out. Oh, Bhagwan, you also come with me and accompany me and I'll find out. So, okay. So he went, both of them came to the earth and Bhagwan said, I'm not going to come up to you. You want to test him? You go and test him. I will be lying. There was a farm. This man was working in the farm. So near the farm, there was a ditch. So he... Bhagwan Vishnu said, I will sit, I will hide myself in this ditch. You go and find out the effect of the name Ghamochan. So what happened? She went. And Bhagwan told her, you don't go in this dressed as Lakshmi. This fellow will get shocked. He's never seen anything so glamorous and beautiful. You please dress as an ordinary woman and go there. Otherwise he'll faint first of all. So she dressed as an ordinary lady and she went there. And when she went there, he was doing Ghamochan, 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 Ghamochan. Lakshmiji went chum, 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 chum. He didn't even look up. Ghamochan, Ghamochan, Ghamochan. Lakshmiji said, my dear, what are you doing? He's saying Ghamochan, Ghamochan. He didn't even bother. He says, whose name are you speaking? He says, oh, your husband's. That man was shocked. What? Lakshmiji is saying, what are you chanting? My husband's name? Where is my husband? Ah, he's lying in the ditch over there. What? Immediately Lakshmiji went back to Vishnu and said, my prostrations, O Lord, whether they know, whether they chant rightly or wrongly, whether they know or they don't know, the effect of your name is there. Will you all remember? When you want to call a form, how do you call? When you want to call a person, how do you call? You call him by his name. Is it true or not? So you say Rama, Rama, and Rama comes. Have you understood that? That is it. That's the power. I can go on and on. I will only say japa is one of the most beautiful spiritual practices which can be. You know, you can do it when you are doing all your actions, especially if you are doing mechanical actions. So many of your actions are mechanical, isn't it true? At that time. You may have heard this very famous story of this genie who caught hold of this man and said, look, I will be your willing servant. Only on one condition, you keep giving me work. If you don't give me work, I'll eat you up. So this man said, fantastic, I don't have to pay for any servants. Here is a mufat ki servant. Okay, fine, you come over. And then what happened? The genie would come and says, tell me what. He says, wash off all these clothes. The genie would wash it in a few minutes and now says, give me work. Then, okay, finish cooking food. Food is finished in 5 minutes' time. Give me work. Clean up the house. Finish. Give me work. And it would keep. If you don't give me, I'm going to eat you up. If you don't give me, I'm going to eat you up. Then it became a problem. The same genie became a problem. He says, what do I do with it? Went to his guru and said, what do I do with this guy? He's going to eat me up if I don't give him work. He says, very simple. Take a pole. Put it in your courtyard. Whenever he comes to you and you don't have any work, ask him to go up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. Then when you have work, say, ajao, finish this work. Let him finish the work and he comes back. Have you all understood? So when you have to do some work, put your mind to it. When your mind is empty, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Have you understood? Otherwise this mind eats you up. Have you understood that? How to control the mind? This is one technique. Have you? A lot of people were asking me how to control, how to this, how to this. This is one technique. Give it. The minute you do a mechanical action, the minute, Swamiji, shall we do that in the lecture? Please don't. you are supposed to listen. Don't do Om Namah Shivaya inside. But when you're doing mechanical actions, and we do that a lot, when you're driving, you know how mechanical, let the mind. So many mechanical actions you do keep this. Supposing you don't remember all the other things I told, Om Namah Shivaya, when you are bathing, when you are brushing, whatever. When I say Om Namah Shivaya, I don't mean Om Namah Shivaya. It could be any name of the Lord. It just doesn't matter. Every name is effective. Are you all understanding that? Yes or no? It doesn't matter if it's Allah or it is Christ. It just doesn't matter because it's the name of the Lord, right? And you want to discover a new name of the Lord, that's fine. Okay? But you call it the name of the Lord and you chant it, doesn't matter. No, I don't like any of these names. I like Munnu. Okay, if you think Munnu is name of Lord, call him Munnu and do it. Because there are so many, haven't we discovered names like Lala, Lala. Lala is not a name of God. But we said Lala, don't we say? Lala Ji, Lala, Lala. Lala, okay fine, Lala. Baba, Baba also. Kaka, Kaka also. Every name is fine. As long as you know is the name of the Lord, everything can happen. Right. So, japa is a very, very effective sadhana. Then you have what is called tarpanam. You know, you remember your ancestors. Now, this is also another thing which we all must understand. See, you and I are what we are because of our parents being what they are. Do you all agree with me? Yes or no? Most of us have value of our parents only when we get our own children. Agreed? Bolo. Then you realize, my God, what all they did for us. So effectively they did so many things. What are you doing? By doing tarpanam, you are remembering your ancestors with gratefulness. You're remembering all the good things that we got from our ancestors with gratefulness. Are you understanding that? You are acknowledging. You don't get arrogant then. You realize all this is what we've got. It's something which is precious. You know, I many times feel this. In many houses, there is some cultural tradition going on for hundreds of years. Maybe there's a puja going on. Hundreds of years the puja is going. One fine morning, the daughter-in-law comes and says, I don't believe in all this. And she just drops the whole thing and stopped. Isn't it? The tradition took hundreds of years to come into existence, and one day it can stop forever. आर यू विथ मी? बोलो, व्हाट इज दिस? डू वी हैव अ राइट टू डू दैट? जस्ट बिकॉज यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द ट्रेडिशन डजंट मीन इट्स ऑब्सोलीट. हैव यू गॉट द पॉइंट? You may not understand. You don't understand half the things. In fact, there are, so every place that you go, there are traditions. We follow all those traditions completely. But our own traditions, we want to break and we want to drop them and we think it's all very, it's very crazy, you know, in terms of, you know, even dress codes or sometimes like that. You know, in the Western culture also, if you go to a certain place, it's always tie and suit. However uncomfortable a tie, and a tie is extremely uncomfortable. Do you agree with me? Bolo na, yes or no? It is an uncomfortable dress because the first thing a person does the minute he is relaxed, he loosens his tie. If it wasn't so uncomfortable, why do you do that? Are you getting my point? So that is fine. That we will all do, you know, we almost choke ourselves. But if they tell you that, no, now you have to go to the temple, wear a this. Nahi, nahi, I believe in comfort. So shorts pehrine mandire jaise. Yes or no? કરે છે કે નથી કરતા લોકો? ના પણ હવે અરે ઇઝ કમ્ફર્ટેબલ. હેવ યુ ગોટ ધીસ પોઈન્ટ? સો ધેરફોર પ્લીઝ રિમેમ્બર, યુ નો ધેર ઇઝ અ સેન્ક્ટિટી, ધેર ઇઝ યુ નો અ પ્લેસ ફોર એવરીથિંગ એન્ડ અ વે ઓફ ડુઇંગ થિંગ્સ એન્ડ ધ સેન્ક્ટિટી ઓફ અ પ્લેસ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો ધેર. ધેર ઇઝ અ મીનિંગ ટુ એવરીથિંગ ઓલ્સો. સ્વામીજી, ઓલ ધીઝ આર ઓબ્સોલીટ, ધેન વાય ડુ યુ સો સ્ટુડિયસલી ફોલો ટ્રેડિશન્સ, અધર ટ્રેડિશન્સ? Are you with me? Yes. All other traditions we follow very, if anyone else makes whatever norms, we will follow that if it comes from the West, if it comes from the United States of, what? America. Everything we will follow. If they tell you have to do it that way, we will do it that way. So now it is said, Tarpanam is one of the, few more are there. Have you ever heard of a Homa? I want to explain the basis of these spiritual practices. Have you done Homa? Ever? Homa? You got married, right? How did you get married? There was a Havan. Havan, okay, you can call it Havan also. Havan and Homa is the same. Yajna? Have you seen that? Every ceremony in India is done in the presence of fire. Are you aware of that? Every. And that is why you get up in the morning and your first puja starts with lighting of a lamp. By the way, why do you do puja? How do you do puja? In the puja, you do arati, then you offer food to the Lord, then you bathe. Now, in what krama are you supposed to do? And what is the basis? What is the understanding of puja? Why do you do it that way? Why do you first not do arati and then give food? And first give food and then do arati? Swamiji, we do it the opposite. Aarti karin pachi? No, bhog is first and then the aarti. Why do you do all these things? I'll just give you a little brief this of understanding of all that tomorrow. And as I already told you, I will also give you a little understanding of the life plan. Okay? My whole emphasis today was that our whole day has to become what? Spiritually alive. And we think of higher things all the time. And I told you, the mantras are not that important as the bhava behind that, okay? So if you learn the mantras, very good. If you don't, it's okay. Just the bhava. In each thing that you do, the bhava becomes more important. And then it becomes sadachara. Okay, we'll see more of it tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya पूर्णमेव वशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम. श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम.